Good morning, everyone. Thank you so much for joining me at Pandamonium Publishing House, pandemoniumpublishing.com online. And we are continuing with our countdown to literacy. Today is day two, and I will be reading The Extreme Supreme Dogwalker, Darlene. This is written by yours truly, illustrated by Alex Gubar. And let's take a look at the back here, okay? So Darlene is a supreme extreme dog walking machine. She lives for positively precious pooches and prides herself on being a professional dog walker with gadgets galore. She's got every situation covered, from bad bone breath to tender toes and tootsies. She's ready to take on any challenge. Follow along as she entertains the pack and keeps them out of trouble. Now, Alex drew this because she really thought that it would be cool to show the streets and where the dog park is and where all the dogs along the park live, which I thought was a really great idea. So we're going to get into this, and I'm going to read this for you. I'm just going to change the view here to two-page view. And there we go. So this book I wrote for my nephew, Miles. He's going to be a year old in January. So time flies. And I wrote this for just before he was born. So this came out in 2021. And here we go. The Extreme Supreme Dog Walker, Darlene. My name is Darlene, and I live for dogs. I love all types of dogs: fluffy, chubby, small, skinny, big, sneaky, and cheeky. Dogs come in all shapes and sizes, just like people do. I really love this kind of vignette page that shows all of her gadgets. So she's got a water bottle, extra water bottle, this vegan leather tool belt, an ankle pouch, spray, dog bags, all of this kind of stuff. So this was really, really fun. And I'll tell you how I thought about the story, writing it, when I was kind of mulling over this idea. I take my job very seriously, and that's how I earned the title of Extreme Supreme Dog Walker, Darlene. The people in my neighborhood need their dogs walked because they are at work or on vacation, have broken bones, or just run out of time. No matter what, I always get the job done. I make sure that their pets are well taken care of. We've got a wagging tail, a full belly, big bowl of food, hydration, healthy bones, big smiles, silky coat, yummy snacks. I arrive at Luna's house first. She's still a puppy, but a big one. She loves to pull on the leash, but I have a solution for that. I just have to keep her focused. So this is obviously based on my own dog, Luna, who is a Rottweiler. This looks exactly like her necklace. And we've got a treat here on a fishing pole, which is really cute. Such a good idea. She needs as much exercise as possible to tire her out. True story. I think Luna's mom is pretty tired too. Again, true story. She always looks like she's got a million things to do. There's me. And I love the little things that Alex put in here for features and little details. This panda snow globe. I've got this on my fridge actually, and sticky notes and books and paper everywhere. So yes, she definitely got my essence, that's for sure. And same with Luna's. Then it's off to Ruby's house. She's got a big, fluffy, luxurious coat that sometimes gets tangled, but I can solve it, no problem. Ruby is the name of my parents' golden retriever, so inspiration definitely comes from real life. I have to keep up on her grooming routine because just last week I found a family of birds making a nest in her fur. Thankfully, I found them a new place to live. Next, I pick up Cuddles. He doesn't have the best breath, but it's no problem for me at all. I've got just the thing to freshen him up. He loves it when I squeeze him and kiss him, and I know brushing his teeth and keeping them healthy is important for his whole body. Ketchup and Mustard are twins. They have a bit of a problem with keeping up with the pace, but it's cool. I just have to help them. I have just the thing to help them out. I got a little tongue tied there. These are Ketchup and Mustard, wiener dogs on roller skates, which I thought was really funny and really cute. Little dogs have little legs, and sometimes they can't go as fast as the big dogs. That just means that we have to go a bit slower or let them take breaks when they need them. Kevin does not like to walk on the pavement, grass, rocks, or, well, anywhere really, but it's okay. He's just a bit nervous. He loves getting outside and enjoying the scenery with the rest of the pack. Sometimes Kevin is scared of loud noises, but he just needs me to stay calm and let him know that I'm here to protect him as the pack leader. I think this is so funny. She's got this special like belt for him so he doesn't have to touch the floor. Daisy is a bit of a celebrity. She had a modeling contract for a famous dog food company a few years back, so she likes to be treated extra specially. I make sure I meet her expectations so that everyone is happy. She can be a bit demanding at times, but I know she means well. Angus is last. He's a big fella with, well, piles of, it's no problem. I can easily clean up any mess he makes. He eats a lot of food and drinks a whole bunch of water because he needs so much energy to run and jump and play with the other dogs in the pack. My job is to make sure that each dog is happy, healthy, and exercised. That's why I have to be alert for any type of danger, because as every supreme extreme dog walker knows, predators can be lurking anywhere. So look at all these distractions. This is definitely a predator, this cat here. We've got garbage, we've got pigeons, we've got a squirrel, which is their favorite, we've got a raccoon. She's got these special goggles that help her identify the prey coming up. the predators coming up. Skunks, cats, squirrels, little dogs with big attitudes, bouncy balls, small kids with food, and overly excited grandmas and grandpas can be distracting to the dogs. I know they just want to say hello, but sometimes it's better if we just smile from a distance. I love the expression on this dog. I love that this is loading. This grandma has hearts for pupils, which is so funny. And here are all the distractions again. My pack's favorite place is the park. We play all types of games there. I play stick fetch with Luna, frisbee with Ruby. I push cuddles on the swings. I play jump rope with Ketchup and Mustard. I play chess with Kevin. I make sure Daisy is comfortable and I pick up after Angus. As long as every dog is happy, so am I. It's the end of the day and all the dogs are tuckered out. I hope that they enjoy all of the fun we have and they know how much I love spending time with them and that they love spending time with me too. Being a supreme extreme dog walker is a dream come true. And this is where we show where everybody lives. Luna lives here. We've got Ruby over here, Kevin, Daisy, Angus, Ketchup and Mustard, and Cuddles. Speaking of Cuddles, there's Luna. And then we have the different facts in the back of the dog. So Rottweiler, Roman legions use these dogs to herd and guard cattle. Great Dane, they're the tallest dog breed in the world, but not the heaviest. Wiener dog, Dachshund, was the first Olympic mascot appearing in 1972. A German Shepherd, they ranked as the third smartest dog right after Border Collies and Poodles. And Poodles, is this breed was originally bred to be hunters specializing in hunting water birds. So we wanted to put those facts in there. And then again, here's our pieces of our kids collection. We have tons and tons and tons of choices if you go to pandemoniumpublishing.com. And there's a menu at the top that says book listing. And that's where you can find the themes and what every book is about. A little tiny peek into what they talk about. So that is Darlene Extreme, the Extreme Supreme Dog Walker Darlene. And I actually had this idea when I was walking Luna as a puppy, because I felt like I had to take so many things with me. And it was one of those times where I was like, what would make me the best at being a dog walker? Like, what kind of tools and gadgets and all of these things would I need to be the most extreme supreme dog walker ever? And that's where the book came from. So I hope that you enjoyed it. And I really hope that you'll check out pandemoniumpublishing.com, our book listing, to see all of the different titles that we have. So thank you so much for joining me. And I will be back tomorrow for another story.